Good evening, Mr. Harari. Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us tonight. My question indeed is a bit more personal. You've called yourself a prophet tonight, or you use the word.
I repeatedly denied.
Yeah, well.
I mean, all this story about Jesus rising from the dead and being the Son of God, this is fake news.
Yuval Noah Harari, a spokesperson and advisor for the World Economic Forum and Klaus Schwab's right-hand man, people say, I don't think I've ever seen somebody encompass the Antichrist and the goals of the Antichrist more than this person. This guy is pushing for practically new religions based off technology. He calls and openly says that we're going to be having entities living among us that are not human. And then he's pushing and absolutely supporting in multiple video interviews that we need to be surveyed and have surveillance that is technology implanted under our skin. I mean, it's shocking. And not only that, as you see in the opening clip, he is openly, absolutely, completely against the God of the Bible and against the belief in God.
And I think that fake news have been with us for thousands of years. Just think of the Bible.
But there is a concern that...
Which is then very strange, because then he mixes on out of that into saying, well, we're going to have religions that are going to come out of Silicon Valley in the future. Religions of technology. I mean, this guy is so strange. It's like the weirdest thing ever. So for this video, I'm just going to lay out the clips in a certain sequence and not really going to stop off and talk about them really too much at all, because we all really know the end times is coming. There will be the Antichrist, a figure who will rule in the end. There will be one world government, one world control of government, and one world currency. All of that is going to take place. So just knowing that truth that is all told to us through Revelation, mainly Revelation 13, as well as Matthew 24, we can know those truths and then look and listen at what guys like this are saying and just absolutely see how it's fulfilling that prophecy and moving towards that. I mean, unlike anything before. Again, with this guy, all these other people are like setting these systems up, like pushing these systems in different ways, but this guy is really encompassing it in almost every single fashion of all of those angles of prophecy and pushing and supporting those in every single aspect. 1 John chapter 2 verse 18 says, little children, it is the last hour, and as you have heard, the Antichrist is coming. Even now, many Antichrists have come, by which we know that it is the last hour. These types of teachings, these open blasphemies and open disrespect against really everyone, not only Christian, but everyone who believes on God on the earth, is really just a sign of the times, a very telling sign, and really pointing towards the last hour. And so now I'll play the sequence of those clips and then briefly talk about it at the end.
The next big projects of humankind will be to overcome old age and death and to basically upgrade humans into gods. In the Bible, in the book of Genesis, basically the first thing God does is to create animals and plants and humans according to his wishes. We are now trying to gain this divine ability to ourselves. And in a way, we are even reaching beyond what ancient religions ascribed to the gods. Because the gods, like Jehovah in the Bible, they could create only organic beings. If you're a creationist and you look at the world, so all these animals, all these plants, God created them and they are all organic. Now humans are trying to do better than that.
Science is replacing evolution by natural selection with evolution by intelligent design. Not the intelligent design of some god above the clouds, but our intelligent design. And the intelligent design of our clouds, the IBM cloud, the Microsoft cloud, these are the new driving forces of evolution.
We are really acquiring divine powers of creation and destruction. We are really upgrading humans into gods. We are acquiring, for instance, the power to re-engineer life.
Humans are now hackable animals. You know, the whole idea that humans have, you know, they have this soul or spirit and they have free will and nobody knows what's happening inside me. So whatever I choose, whether in the election or whether in the supermarket, this is my free will, that's over.
We don't have any answer in the Bible what to do when humans are no longer useful to the economy. You need completely new ideologies, completely new religions.
and they are likely to emerge from Silicon Valley or from Bangalore and not from the Middle East. And they are likely to give people visions based on technology. Everything that the old religions promised, happiness and justice and even eternal life, but here on earth with the help of technology and not after death with the help of some supernatural being. But in 200 years, earth is dominated by entities which are more different from us than we are different from Neanderthals. Different bodies, different brains, different minds. Artificial intelligence and technology in general are going to break out of this limited realm of organic biology and create something completely new.
Surveillance, people could look back in 100 years and identify the coronavirus epidemic as the moment when a new regime of surveillance took over, especially surveillance under the skin, which I think is maybe the most important development of the 21st century, is this ability to hack human beings, to go under the skin, collect biometric data, analyze it, and understand people better than they understand themselves. This, I believe, is maybe the most important event of the 21st century.
Maybe in a couple of decades, when people look back, the thing they will remember from the COVID crisis is this is the moment when everything went digital. And if this is this was the moment when everything became monitored, that we agreed to be surveyed all the time, not just in authoritarian regimes, but even in democracies. And maybe most importantly at all, this was the moment when surveillance started going under the skin. Because really we haven't seen anything yet. I think the big process that's happening right now in the world is hacking human beings, the ability to hack humans, to understand deeply what's happening within you, what makes you go. For that, the most important data is not what you read and who you meet and what you buy, it's what's happening inside your body. So we had these two big revolutions, the computer science revolution, or the infotech revolution, and the revolution in the biological sciences. And they are still separate, but they are about to merge. They are merging around, I would say, the biometric sensor. It's the thing, it's the gadget, it's the technology that converts biological data into digital data that can be analyzed by computers. And having the ability to really monitor people under the skin, this is the biggest game changer of all.
What we've seen so far, it's corporations and governments collecting data about where we go, who we meet, what movies we watch. The next phase is the surveillance going under our skin. Mass surveillance systems established even in democratic countries, which previously rejected them. And we also see a change in the nature of surveillance. Previously, surveillance was mainly above the skin. Now it's going under the skin. Governments want to know not just where we go or who we meet. Above all, they want to know what is happening under our skin. What's our body temperature? What's our blood pressure? What is our medical condition?
It's truly quite shocking, isn't it? I don't think I've ever seen anybody encompass really just the ideologies and the total picture of what the Antichrist will be pushing and the end times truth that we know of, just complete control, complete new religion, complete mocking of God, blaspheming in a way that's like not like anyone in the past really has. Like this, the way this guy blasphemes is very strange. It's in like a very scientific mocking, but scientific and culturally like manipulated. It's very strange. It's unlike anything I think I've ever seen. This is somebody to definitely keep our eye on, because what this guy is pushing and what he is really trying to teach is absolutely the systems of the Antichrist and the end times that we will see. And so, of course, we don't know the full picture. And as infuriating and as irritating as it is, we got to be praying for these people, for the Davos people, for all these people. We don't know who the end times deceivers are. I mean, at one time we were all lost, and God even says, you know, the way God looks at sin in comparison to how we do, God says, you know, if you even looked at a woman with lust, then you've committed adultery, or if you've even committed one sin, you've broken them all. So even though it's very hard to watch and listen to these people who are absolutely trying to encourage the most evil and destructive and anti-freedom systems that the world will ever see, ultimately pushing towards the beast system, we do need to pray that these people will be delivered, that their eyes will be open, because they are just so completely deceived, thinking that they know everything and that their God of science will answer all their questions. But we really do need to pray for them. God will reveal all things to all people, and one day, God will have the vengeance. You know, we don't have, it's not for us to take out, as God says, vengeance is His. So let's pray for them in hopes that their eyes will be open, and then maybe they can confuse their plans. Because if one of those guys' eyes were opened, I mean, great things could happen. That's like if the Yanuka, you know, false prophet potential guy in Israel, if his eyes were open to the truth of the gospel, it would just really be a good thing if these people's eyes were open, because it would just change things in a dramatic way. And we know that in the very end, God has His ways, and so we have to keep our complete hope in that. And Psalm 2 is a great chapter for realizing and understanding this truth. And that says, "Why do the nations rage and the people plot a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against His anointed, saying, let us break their bonds in pieces and cast away their cords from us. But He who sits in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall hold them in derision. Then He shall speak to them in His wrath and distress them in His deep displeasure." And then it goes on to talk about Jesus, the true King, ruling, the Son of God, with the nations as His inheritance, and how the whole earth will follow Him, and everything is in His hands absolutely, completely. So thank God one day that will come. These people think they have their plans. They think they're going to live forever, and they have all these plans to do all this, and they are massively mistaken. So hopefully their eyes are opened before they have vengeance, because as much as these people are a massive annoyance right now on the earth with trying to just implement absolute tyrannical rules on just the regular person, the fact is that these people will forever be in torment in hell if they don't turn their lives to Jesus. So let's pray that their eyes are opened. Thanks for watching. Keep your hope and trust and faith in Jesus. He will see us through these days. He hasn't left us yet. He never will. Thanks for watching, and God bless.